Welcome, everybody. We have a really, really exciting video today. This is going to be very unique. We're going to take a look at the Middle Persian language, which is the Persian language that was spoken up until around the 8th or the 9th century, where it started to move into the modern Persian language, and see how well the present day modern Persian speakers can understand it. So what we have here is a few sentences that Buya is going to read, and Mahia and Nagma are going to see how well they can understand it. We're going to start with the more simple sentences, and then we're going to move to the more challenging ones. And I just want to say we are conducting this in English because that's what we usually do with all our videos, because I'm sure a lot of people will ask why we're not speaking Persian.
Hello everyone, I'm Mahia, I'm from Iran, and I'm a polyglot and YouTuber based in Beijing, China, and I'm really happy to be here and I'm really excited. Let's go.
Hello, everyone. It's great to be back here on one of your videos. Bahadur, it's my third time, and I'm very excited to be here today in this video. I am Nagme. I'm from Iran, but I am based in Turkey. I'm a PhD student, and on Instagram, I blog about studying in Turkey and general information about living and studying in Turkey.
Hello, everybody. I'm Puya. I'm from Iran, Tehran, and I'm glad to be here to participate in this video. We're gonna talk about Pahlavi language or Middle Persian language, which is more referred to Sasanian Pahlavi. We have two different type of Pahlavi, Parthian Pahlavi and Sasanian Pahlavi. In this video, we want to talk about Sasanian Pahlavi, the before Islam, before Arab conquest. We have different language derived from Pahlavi language in this day, like Tati, like Lori, and all of them based on Pahlavi language and are in the same family language. So if you can, if you see some similarities between these languages, are very natural. And so we can find some similarities between Pahlavi and, for example, Tati, Polishi, or Gilaki, or all of them. Okay, let me read the first sentence. Man Okan Raven. Man Okan Raven. Okan, Okan, not Okan. Okan, man. Okan Raven.
I went to that house.
House, yes. Raven, I
will go.
No, I go.
I go.
I go to Okan.
I go. Oh, that was good.
Yes, okay, it's simple. It was so simple. It will get harder.
Was it though?
Let me say something about word man. In Persian language, at the first ages of Sasanian Pahlavi, they used two different words for man. I means as I, and man or me. If you are the subject of the verb, they said as. If you are the object of the verb, they say ma. So as, you can see its footprint in German language as ich. You can see its footprint in French language, je, in Italian, io, and in English, I. And all of them have are cognates, have the same root, and man. Even man also means to think. Man means I, me, and also to think. And for example, we have some derived word from man, dushman. Dushman means who think bad. You are my dushman, you are my enemy. You think bad about me, you want bad things happen to me. So you are my dushman, and human means who think good about others. The second one, it's a bit harder. اگرت پاسخ کرم ننگم بابت گران.
Oh, yeah, this is
okay. I break it into two. اگرت پاسخ کرم اگرت پاسخ کرم. Okay, just say this.
If I respond to you.
Okay, right. ننگم بابت گران.
I will respond you nicely.
No,
I will not tell you anything. I will not tell you anything. Get on, maybe.
You can say it in two different sentences. They're not. You can break it into two sentences, two different sentences. First sentences, you said it right. اگر پاسخ کردم, if I answer you, ننگم بابت گران. ننگم بابت گران.
If I answer you, it's better for me to keep silent.
It will be a shame for me. If I answer you, it will be a shame for me. ننگم. Nang means shame.
Nang.
Yes. Nang. It's my shame. It's for me. It's a shame for me. It's a big shame for me if I answer you.
I think if I see the way it's written, it's much easier for me to get. Actually, I'm cheating. I'm writing what I hear.
That's great. No, that's actually a good idea. I should have said that. Maybe you can just write down what he says and then try to piece them together like a puzzle.
Well, you study ancient languages. I say it's like a puzzle. You can find some connections between these languages and other foreign languages, and it's a puzzle.
زردوشت رسد اود ود کردنی تو پدن بگوبد.
Okay, I start from the first. Okay.
زردوشت,
okay.
Zoroaster.
زردوشت.
زردوشت.
دوشت.
Yes. Okay.
That sounds like German to me.
Rasid. Ud vat kardani to vat kardani to.
Ud vat kardani to.
To vat kardani to padden begove.
The last word of the sentence is probably to say beguyat, yes.
Okay.
Isn't it?
Okay. Then can be a bit puzzling here. I should help you. Then means religion. Din. Yeah.
Din.
Religion, but here means Avesta.
Okay, first, Zardusht came to Avesta?
Arrived.
Okay, Zardusht will arrive and say something to Avesta, to God, to...
the holy book.
Yes. Okay. Would it decide? Vat kardani to.
Vat kardan?
Vat kardani to.
To?
Yes.
To means you, probably.
Okay.
So, vat kardani to.
Bad.
Okay.
Bad.
Okay, bad.
Bad kardani to. Your mistake, bad kardani to.
Okay. Your bad deeds, your mistake, yes.
Okay.
Your mistake. Zardusht will arrive and tell your bad deeds, your mistakes to God. Okay.
Just we have one missing word now.
Yes, ut means and.
And.
And Persian, in German, they say und. And there are. In Persian, in informal position, informal situations, we say o. Masalan. Okay, here is water. Obo non, for example.
Obo, yes.
Non. Yes. And it's the fourth sentence. Horsi donog o meno yichrad ku radi ve ayo rosti. Horsi donog ask, yes. Donog.
Knowledgeable. Someone.
No, it's someone. O menogi khrad. Radi.
Bi khrad.
Menogi khrad. Menogi khrad.
Menogi khrad.
Okay. I think a wise person asks someone else.
Okay.
Who's that someone?
Actually, he asked from his own mind. From mind. His own. Who? Radi ve ayob rosti.
Okay, rosti.
Yes.
Truth.
Honest.
Okay, honest.
Can you break down the words in the middle?
Radi or ayob or ve?
Ayob, the whole thing.
Ayob. The whole thing.
Radi ve ayob rosti.
Ayob rosti. Radi ve.
Let me help you by word ve. Ve. If you remember, you changed that the V sound to
be. Ah, be.
Be.
Be. Okay, better.
The fruit?
Oh,
oh, be. Oh, better.
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 Better. Okay. A wise person asks his wisdom.
Okay, his mind.
Truth or better?
Radi. Radi ve ayob rosti.
His own wisdom, whether generosity is better or truth.
Or honesty.
Honesty. Yes. The fifth sentence. Ud panjom ezishni yazdan. Ud aspanji kardagan kardan. It's a bit hard, I know. Okay, just yes, the first part, I would say the second part.
Yazdan means God, like
okay.
Va panjom setayesh yazdan. Or is it?
Yes, exactly.
Yeah, great.
Ezish means to worship.
To worship.
To worship God.
Ud as panji kardagan kardan.
Uh-huh.
I think you just figured out, you just realized ud and kardan.
Ud is
va and.
Okay.
Ud means and. Va
and.
Okay. As panj, you can see in different Iranian language.
Is it like five, to pray five times?
Prayers. I was thinking of
no. Five. No, pray. No, it's pray.
It's that.
Not even close.
Okay.
Let me help you. Kardagan means travelers. Kardagan means travelers. You can do something to travelers, which and make them happy.
Them
okay
exactly.
Right, travelers. It's about hospitality, not let me say. Fradom prosh vistarehed pastan paidagihed.
That sounds like Urdu.
Are you sure accent. You're not speaking German?
That sounds Urdu.
I tried to help you with my accent. I don't know. How can I help you? Fradom prosh vistarehed pastan paidagihed.
Paida, is it paida? Like
yes, exactly.
Mm-hmm. Obvious.
Obvious to appear.
Obvious, yes. And
pan mean like body.
Okay.
Sepas.
Sepas.
Okay. Okay.
Then.
Okay. So something happened at first.
Then body appears.
Fradon prosh vistarehe.
First one.
It looks like first in English.
First. And prosh means the rays of light. Prosh. First, the rays of light vistarehe.
So far we had the first light
first shine. Rays of light we start ahead, then the main body will appear.
It starts to expand.
Gostarde shodan. We have word vast in English means to expanded, extended, vast. Exactly, and it's vistarehed means gostarde shodan. It says the aval ebteda baregahay nur partahay nur gostarde mishavad sepas an peidam mishavad badane asli peidam mishavad. It's talking about sunrise. Fradom is constitutes two parts, Fradon, F, R, and Dom. You can see this F, R in the first word first, at the first of the word first, F, R, and Dom is used to make superlative adjective. Fradon. In Pahlavi, superlative adjective, they made it by dom or tom. But in Avestan language, they added ishta at the end of the adjective to make it superlative. As we can see in English, est, est, and ishta in Avestan. So the word first is something between Pahlavi and Avestan, fr from Pahlavi. And Fara in Persian is exactly the same. FR from Pahlavi and ST from Avestan language and make the word first of English. So there should be a connection between these three languages.
A lot of the terms that you use, actually, if you look at, you'll find cognates of them still being used, which have fallen out of use in modern Persian, but when you study the etymology of Middle Persian terms, you see that, oh, yes, it's connected to some other modern languages today.
Yes, exactly.
And those were the difficult parts. A lot of the words, as we were saying, are still used in modern Persian, just not pronounced the same way, or they're kind of used a little bit in a different sense, not exactly the same.
Okay, from the first, I can see man, khan, Ravim, Nang, Pasokh, Geran, or at the end, Tan, Ezish, Setayesh, and all of them, Yazd, Izad, all of them are guidance.
Thank you so much. This was really, really wonderful. I hope that for people who are watching and who are interested in ancient languages, you find this interesting, and perhaps you find a lot of cognates with different Indo-European languages, which, as we mentioned, are not being used in modern Persian, but still used in some other languages.
Thank you for having us, and can't wait for the next time.
Thank you to make this video about Pahlavi, and I'm so happy about it.
Thank you so much for watching this video, and don't forget to subscribe to Mr. Bahadur's channel and give this video a thumbs up if you like it.
Thank you, and same with Mahi's channel. Definitely go and check it out.
Thank you.
Okay, thank you. Take care and have a good night.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Bye-bye.
Bye. Goodbye.